On this episode of Wayne's Work Vlog, we're going to get this shift handle finally shipped out because I finally got my knife in the mail. It's just your typical eBay 10.5-inch or 12.5-inch Rambo combat survival camping knife. So it's got all the bullshit in it. I think this one, 10 or 12 bucks shipped, and it's got the compass in the bottom end. But what we're after is this. You take out this Allen out of the side here, and the blade, with a little bit of persuasion, will come right out. Then you have your handle with your end cap for a hidden compartment. All you gotta do is cut this off flush with the hilt with a cutting wheel, and then drill the center part out big enough for your shift hole. Once you've done that, you can use the Allen to secure it back, or tap it, or both. This will be getting mailed out to Gilad. He was the first to comment in the United States that wanted the shift knob, so I'll be shipping it out to him. That's just another reason to subscribe to the videos, guys. That way you're instantly notified if I upload a new video, and then you also instantly know if I'm giving something away, because I do give a lot of stuff away. Also, a little side note, if you've not yet purchased a raffle ticket for the 1954 Harley, here's a link to do that, or down in the video description. If you're on mobile, be sure to click the buy button. It's only $20, and you're entered in for a chance to win a 1954 Harley Davidson. We've got 13 days left in the month, so we got to get all 1,000 tickets to sell. Otherwise, I will be refunding all the money back to the buyers. All right, something I had been meaning to do to this anyway. I've got this Jamaican $1. So I had meant to JB weld it to the end here to cover this kind of scratch. I don't know what that is. And I never got around to it. So since I'm going to be milling it off, I figure I'll go ahead and knock this out for you guys, and then throw it in the mail as soon as it's done curing. There. Hopefully you guys can see that. It's a $1 from 2008 Jamaica. Anyway, obviously if the new owner that's getting it for free doesn't like it, he can pop it off or put whatever he wants up there. If you want to actually use the hidden compartment, I recommend when you buy the survival kit, make sure it has one of these containers. Dump out the fishing kit if you don't want to keep that, of course. And then you keep this, take it to Ace Hardware or some other hardware store, and find a spring about the same size or maybe smaller around than this is, and about an inch and a half at the most long, real soft spring. And then when you drop the spring down into the handle, and when you drop this down in there, it'll be spring loaded, and you can put the cap down on top of it, and then when you take the cap off of the handle, this will pop up enough for you to actually pull it out of the handle, and then you can put whatever you want in there. Now, the easiest way I found to get the blade out of the handle was to clamp the blade into a vise, like so, off to the side of the jaws. And then I hit lightly right here on the hilt with a hammer until it vibrated itself loose. I can repaint this later if I need to. I was probably gonna paint it a different color anyway. Now I need to take the cutting wheel and cut this nub right here off so the hilt is flush. Now, because this is aluminum, it does conduct a lot of heat, so definitely wear gloves. It's like nuclear hot all the way up to here. Now that we've got that knocked off, we can take a sandpaper wheel and grind this smooth. Once it's grinded smooth, we can drill the hole out a little bigger and then paint it. Now, if you saw what I was doing there at the end, holding the end of this to, there's a fan basically that keeps these gears cool, and it blows air out from around the sides here. And just like aluminum heats up really easily and disperses the heat evenly like a heat sink, it also cools off really easily. So I was actually holding the hot surface to the fan, and it became almost instantly cooler and easier to handle. Also, when aluminum gets hot, it wants to bind up more in the grinding wheel, so it's better to keep it as cool as possible. Don't work one area too hard because it will destroy the integrity of the aluminum. It's called annealing it, but we're going to try and get a notch into the center here and then drill a hole dead center the same size as our original shifter. Night. you can see that's pretty close enough for what we're going to be doing. But I'm gonna go ahead and get this hole as big as the other shifter. Probably going to use the lock screw to hold it on for now. You can see the hole there, and it should be fine. I can also thread it later. I believe I have this tap and die set. Grind this a little smooth and then paint it. All right, all shined up nice and bright. I can paint it, I can leave it, whatever. If you intend to tap this to thread onto here, you need to drill this a half size, maybe one size smaller, and then tap your threads into it so it screws on. I did it a little bit bigger so it slides right on and off. And a way to keep this from wobbling too much is I'm gonna wrap a little bit of electrical tape around it before I slide it on so it's nice and tight. And then I'll tighten down the Allen key to hold it on, starting at the bottom and then working my way up so the overlaps go down, keeps the tape from wadding up. Do it one wrap at a time so that you don't have to take any tape off. You can just add more if it's not tight enough. There we go, one layer. And that makes it a lot more snug. Now I can take the Allen key, screw it right in, just a couple of turns. And then I'm gonna drop a drop of blue Loctite on it. I know this is a red bottle. Loctite thinks they're funny, I guess. So red bottles have blue written on them and blue bottles have red written on them. It's hilarious. Just a little drop, rub it into the threads, take the Allen wrench, screw it right on in. You don't want to over tighten it because obviously this is aluminum, it will strip. You just want to get it to where it's embedded in the tape and it doesn't twist. There we go, nice and sturdy. Then we take our compass end cap, probably going to make a paracord, kind of like dragon's tail. Comment below if you want to see a video on how to do that. And then once screwed down, you have your Bowie knife shifter. If you liked the video, click the like button. If you want to subscribe so you're instantly notified and you get wind of these giveaways as soon as they happen. First person to comment usually is who I'm going to be giving it to, as long as you're in the United States. I don't like shipping internationally. So be sure to subscribe. That way you know as soon as there's a new video up. And as always, guys, keep on modding.